Desertification and a still growing population of humans require solutions how to produce food without destroying natural habitats and resources of other species. Greenhouses create a protected environment for plants and therefore provide higher harvests on a given area. But often large greenhouse compounds create a kind of desert by themselves, deserts of glass and plastic membranes. In modern climate, greenhouses need to be heated in winter. For the production of 1 kilogram of tomatoes in a greenhouse, 1.4 kilos of carbon dioxide are emitted on average. In hot and dry desert areas, greenhouses require a lot of energy for air conditioning or intense vaporization of water to keep the temperature at a moderate level inside. Common greenhouses offer very little protection against sunlight in summer or heat transmission during the winter. Therefore, they need heating in the winter and shading plus ventilation in the summer. Through air ventilation, vaporized water gets lost. Following concepts have been combined for the Pneumo Planet greenhouse design. Inflatable structures are even lighter than steel and glass structures. They are easily prefabricated, transported, and stored, but they don't offer sufficient protection from extreme cold or heat. A bottle garden preserves a sealed microbiosphere where plants grow and decompose in an endless biological cycle. No water is lost and no matter ever needs to be added or taken out. This picture shows the oldest officially known bottle garden, built by David Latimer in 1960. It hasn't been opened since 1972. The mass of the soil stores temperature and reacts slowly to the temperature changes above ground. The deeper you go underground, the less the temperature changes throughout the seasons. The temperature curve throughout the seasons is delayed as well. Also, temperature changes less between day and night, even at a few centimeters underground. By covering buildings with soil or using caves as a living space, the effect of flattening the annual temperature curve has been used throughout history on all continents. A common light steel and glass structure would collapse under the weight of the deposit, but an airtight inflatable structure can easily carry that load. This inflatable greenhouse design was derived from the research on the Pneumo planet Mars habitat, a concept by architect Thomas Herzig, who brings in 14 years of experience with designing inflatable structures through his brand called Pneumocell. This is a derived application on Earth as a greenhouse in hot and dry climate. The advantages are following. There is no loss of water in the closed space. Water vaporizes during the day and condensates at night on the walls and ceiling, from where it flows back to the soil. The thick deposit of soil on the ceiling shields the strong sun radiation from high angle at noon. From the sides facing north and south, diffused light enters, as well as the welcome sunlight from a low angle in winter. Pipes are guided through the ceiling and under the structure. At night, when the temperature considerably drops, cold air is blown through these pipes and cools the soil. Thus, the cool mass of the soil absorbs heat from the interior space through its cool surface. The Pneumo Planet greenhouse concept also makes sense in cold climates, since it also works providing a warmer indoor climate without additional heating. Additional sunlight is reflected inside through mirrors. The soil is not cooled at night, but heated through warm air during the day in summer. Only the southern front, from where direct sun radiation can be expected, is transparent, while the north and the ceiling is covered with a thick layer of soil for heat storage and insulation. With the funding by the Austria Wirtschaftsservice, we were able to develop a small prototype in 2020. For budget reasons, this first prototype was not to be installed in the desert, but on a meadow in Austria as a version for moderate climate. We analyzed the conditions. We made calculations on base of the average daily sun irradiation for each month and compared that to the optimal required light conditions and temperature conditions for plants. While on a bright summer day, light intensity is 100,000 lux. On a cloudy day, it is only 4,000 to 15,000 lux. Photosynthesis starts at 1,000 lux and increases with light intensity up to a peak at 12,000 lux. Anything above does not lead to more photosynthesis and only carries the risk of overheating the greenhouse. Also, temperature has an effect on photosynthesis. Starting from above 0 degree, photosynthesis increases analogous to the temperature with a peak between 24 and 30 degrees. Above this point, it is reduced again. The geometry of the cylindrical greenhouse was designed in a way to gain maximum of sunlight in winter and to cover most of the surface with soil. Tubes with fans inside provide a soft airstream in order to improve heat exchange with the surrounding soil. On base of the given data about outside temperature, solar irradiation, and the heat and light transmissions of the structure, we calculated the heat balance and light conditions inside the greenhouse for each month. Our calculations resulted in these diagram curves and their effect to each other. The annual diagram curve above shows the average daily solar irradiation on a horizontal square meter with its peak end of June. The annual curve below shows the temperature. The blue diagram line shows the annual temperature curve 3 meters under the soil. This curve is flatter with less extreme peaks. The air temperature peaks follow with some delay the peaks of the solar irradiation, while the soil temperature peaks are delayed to September and March versus the air temperature peaks in July and January. For photosynthesis, a maximum of 250 watts per square meter of solar irradiation is optimal. Based on that, the green curve shows the optimal light intensity inside from sunrise to sunset. The structure has a geometry optimized to gain a maximum of sunlight in winter and less in summer. So we can see on the red curve that the interior light conditions come closer to the optimal diagram curve than the outdoor light. This has a positive effect on the interior temperature that also benefits from heat exchange with the surrounding soil, together with the temperature of the soil layers close to the structure on the annual temperature curve is flatter and on a decent higher level than the outside temperature curve. The inside temperature never exceeds 32 degrees Celsius, since above that limit, photosynthesis decreases. Since the Pneumo Planet greenhouse is a sealed volume, we need to take precautions to produce enough CO2 for the photosynthesis. The plan is to decompose organic waste by microorganisms, worms and mushrooms, in the darker area of the greenhouse to release CO2. The inner air pressure needs to be at 60 millibar to hold the weight of the soil. The air inside presses on the membrane with a force of 600 kilogram per square meter. The inflatable structure is reinforced by a net of Dyneema ropes. Thus, the membrane only needs to hold the pressure affecting a small area between the ropes. The geometry of the ropes needs to follow the pressure forces. Since the radial tensile force is twice as high as the longitudinal tensile force, the result is a 60-degree angle grid. We'll be right back. Unfortunately, during the first installation, we did not increase the inner air pressure quickly enough to catch up with the pressure of the layered soil deposit. Through the asymmetric horizontal earth pressure, the structure bent, and a welding joint broke before we could correct it, and the whole structure collapsed. Now, we will build a second, improved prototype. On the new prototype, the transparent part will be placed on top to avoid asymmetric force. In case the structure collapses, it would not be buried under tons of soil. The sunlight coming from a low angle in winter will be reflected and directed into the greenhouse by a mirror wall. Since the position of the mirror wall is higher, there is less risk of other objects casting shadows in winter. An automatic awning will control overheating in summer. The result is an even better illumination than calculated for the previous prototype, and it has a better cooling system in the summer. Ordinary greenhouses receive most of the sunlight in summer, but not much in winter. The Pneumo Planet greenhouse is optimized to receive maximal lighting in winter and does not consume all the green land, which can remain for outdoor agriculture in summer and is a natural habitat for biodiversity. Even more applications can be derived from our patented prefabricated inflatable underground building system. Residential homes. Since living space for humans needs less sunlight than plants, the transparent openings can be smaller and it is easier to keep the temperature on a comfortable level throughout the year without heating or cooling. Reflectors and flexible shading are not needed. Grass grows on top of the building. The production of the lightweight structure has a very small ecological footprint. Most of the building material consists of air and the natural soil, a gift by nature. Indeed, there's an analogy to the very first habitat of every human being, the womb. A thin pressurized membrane surrounded by Mother Nature. We have the concept for sustainable production of food in the desert and anywhere else on our planet. We have the concept for affordable housing in symbiosis with nature. We have the concept for self-sufficient habitats on Mars and on the Moon. Join us! Together we will make these visions come true.